May 30th, when Mickie had the seizure, we had to wait, you know, in the waiting room for 4 hours at Kaiser Fontana. Then, so we were there, you know, waiting 4 hours, and then 2 hours inside the room. But everything is over, they did everything already. The doctor comes back in, say he's concerned about tetanus. I almost started bursting out laughing, but so I asked him, well, why tetanus? Just had a seizure, you know, hit his head. But, well, yeah, because, you know, he hit his head and he has a little blood, and I'm concerned about tetanus. And so I try to ask him, I go, well, doctor, if he was exposed to tetanus, well, when would he, wouldn't he have gotten sick already? And he said, well, you can't be sure, which means he doesn't really know or doesn't want to admit it, that if you get exposed to tetanus when you get hurt or you get cut, you're sick right away. You don't make it to the hospital by the time you're sick. And so then I asked him, well, how long does the vaccine take to take effect? Because you don't become immune right away. He goes, oh, no, blah, 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 blah. And he couldn't give me an answer to that either. And so, you know, he just tried to convince me by saying that, you know, he just wanted to make sure because, you know, just because you've gotten hurt before and you never had tetanus, it doesn't mean you won't get tetanus, you know, one day. But anyways, it's just the fact that, you know, they think that you don't know. Tetanus doesn't live 2 feet above the ground, and it can't live in the presence of oxygen. So if you get, you know, you step on a rusty nail, tetanus can't live in oxygen. So, you know, their theory is just flawed. But anyways, I thought that was interesting. And then when I went back to take him to the neurologist, after we're done talking to the neurologist, he passed me over to the nurse, and then she gives me this paper. You know, so he can have his EEG, giving me the information, what I'm supposed to do. And then she goes, oh, I see he's missing quite a bit of vaccines. I said, oh, yeah, he doesn't get vaccines anymore. And, oh, I'm just asking because I'm supposed to. And then we ended it at that. But I was like, oh, my gosh. And I go, this is why I always avoid going to the doctor, because the minute you do, then they start, you know, pushing the vaccines again. He hasn't had one since he was two, and he's still alive. And, well, minus, you know, the train wreck, the autism, the seizure. So anyways, I just thought I'd share that. I wonder what, you know, other parents have to go through.